Good afternoon, YouTube and Glacially Musical. This video will be posted this evening on 12:30, but if you are seeing this via Glacially Musical, welcome to the, and hopefully most people do, honestly, but I will say welcome to the last day of the worst dystopian nightmare that we have all lived through. So if you're seeing this, you are about to make it through 2020. Here in my house, we've had a lot of personal tragedies and a lot of awful things, but we're not focusing on that today. As it is New Year's, I am celebrating with the champagne of beers, Miller High Life. I realized I was spending too much money on beer, so I decided to buy some cheaper beer. And that I did, but it is the champagne of beers, and it's great for doing things like fishing or celebrating Stanley Cup victories from 2019. No other Stanley Cup victories, because I don't care about them. But what I want to talk to you about today, obviously, my favorite vinyl records of 2020. These are albums that I have acquired either via promo or via my purchasing them. And these are albums that were released on vinyl in 2020. I am not counting anything that was repressed, so Roger Waters, The Wall, Live in Berlin does not count. Also, I think that's probably the only one I got this year. But a couple of honorable mentions I want to give this year. Definitely Barishi, who put out a great record. D'Evangelic did an amazing brutal death metal album. And, you know, there's just, Black Dahlia Murder, of course. The Verminous, however it's pronounced, is fantastic. I'll probably end up listening to that a little bit later this week, probably. Hopefully to ring in 2021 to scare the ghosts away. But without further ado, the first album, and this album was released on vinyl. Did you see my cat? That was my wife's cat, Princess Leia Shabubu. Anywho, this album was originally released in 2019, but it was released on vinyl a year later. Not quite a year, about 6-7 months later, on Needle Juice Records, I believe. This is the Dewey Decibel System by Mega Ran and MC Lars. This was the first music by Mega Ran I've ever owned. I've seen him in concert, love him on Twitter, watch his videos, stream him on Bandcamp, but I hadn't purchased any. And since this album, it actually inspired me to buy two more of his records. I bought Ages, Volume 1, and I am now also waiting for Forever Famicom to arrive. As for MC Lars, I have been a fan of MC Lars since actually the first day I heard of Mega Ran. They were on the same bill with MC Chris at Mojo's in Columbia, Missouri, back in 2011 that I attended. Was it 2011? Yeah, 2011. And I have been a fan of both ever since. This album focuses strictly on books. It's got songs of some of my favorites, favorite novels and plays. There's a song about Julius Caesar. There's Bartleby the Scrivener, Mask of the Red Death, Walden, Gulliver's Travels, 1984. Amazing, amazing record. I purchased, there were two pressings. I decided to pick out the Black and White and Red All Over pressing, because I thought that was funny. It's funny. Came with a nice insert, all that kind of cool stuff as well. But moving on. Another favorite record from this year. Now, this album was originally going to be a vinyl review, but when the pandemic hit, it became too expensive for anybody to do it. And I completely got it, but I wanted a copy of this record, so I purchased it. And then I did a Glacially Musical Roots review on it as well. This is Twin Wizards, Glacial Gods. This is doom metal for people who just can't get enough doom metal. It is big, it is thick, it is thunderous, it is scary. I love this record. I will say I'm pretty sure, like the MC Lars album, all the vinyl is sold out. But even if you're not a vinyl person, it is definitely worth checking out. The pressing itself is also a gorgeous pressing. It is a translucent blue splatter. And it sounds great, feels great. It's an amazing record. definitely, if you haven't heard of that one, check it out. You can also check it out on Glacially Musical to get my expanded thoughts, should you desire a little bit more information. And I'm also going to post links for all the bands in the post I make for this shortly. The next record, this one was a vinyl review. It was one of the few vinyl reviews this year. I did not request it. It was kind of forced upon me, but I accepted gladly. This one is by an artist whom I have reviewed four other times, I guess. Because he was on the album, he was on the album, James Chance and the Contortions. He was the artist for The Mess We Made. He was on, oh God, I know I've got another one that I just can't remember the name of, because I've got three of his. He was also on the Sam Huber records, which were amazing. That would be Tomas Dunker. And give me one second, I gotta check the name of that other record, because it's gonna drive me insane. Don't move. I guess it is just two with his name on it. Oh well. Now, no Leia. Again, Leia. Cats and YouTube, that gets views, right? So, this album, with the James Chance album he was on, it was a punk rock record, but it was proto-punk, so there's, you know, saxophone and trumpets and all that kind of cool stuff. On the next record I did of his, it was soul. He always refers to what he does on the True Groove imprint, Global Soul. And he did another pair of records with Sam Huber. Again, great records, Global Soul. This one is him covering Howlin' Wolf and Willie Dixon. I mean, that is truly amazing, and it's got some very inspired guitar playing. This is the record of his I have been waiting to come out for years without even knowing it. This one originally came out years ago on CD and digital, and this is the first year it's been released on vinyl. You can pick it up at Rough Trade. Now, here's one you're probably not familiar with. The next is the self-titled debut of local St. Louis band Torchlight Parade. Torchlight Parade features a good friend of mine, Danny Nichols. They are a Judas Priest-inspired power metal band. They are extraordinarily theatrical. I've seen them in concert probably six or seven times over the last couple of years. I try to get out when I can, but, you know, life is what it is. The album, it is... This is one of the few times in the history of music in my world where the album is better than the songs on stage, because I prefer the sound of live music. That's my jam. That's my thing. But here, they tightened up their playing. They changed the vocal stylings just a little bit. Dialed back a little bit of the really high notes, and love this record. Again, I believe the vinyl is sold out, but you can definitely get it on CD or digital. Next, Brandy and the Butcher, Dick Circus. Sorry, my daughter had to hear that. This one is cool. It is, oh, how do you describe this one? It's also black. I listened to it yesterday. The day before I recorded this, I listened to this record. It is an awesome, awesome album. It's metal, I guess. It's avant-garde metal. It's kind of folksy. Great record. It's fun. And I mean, that's the biggest thing I could say. It is a fun record to listen to. It's heavy. It's not brutal, because it's not, you know, death metal, but it's a cool record, and I'm glad to have that in my collection. Now, my number one record of the year that came out on vinyl in 2020, not necessarily recorded or released in 2020, but released on vinyl, would be the debut from King Gorm. And I apologize, I've got an old fat cat and a young little cat fighting under my feet. King Gorm is the project, one of the many projects of Francis Roberts, and he is an old man wizard, he's in a pirate metal band, and King Gorm, to me, is the perfect mishmash of pirate metal and stoner metal. Again, it's a metal record that's fun and exciting to listen to. Not sure if there's anything still available on this one. I bought it. I pre-ordered it on Bandcamp, and I have not regretted it one little bit. It is an awesome, awesome, awesome record. But for anybody who's watching this who is not a reader of Glacially Musical but checking me out on YouTube, please like and subscribe. Totally appreciate that. I'm trying to be a thing, and if you can help me be a thing, I would appreciate that. In the meantime, Happy New Year. Bring in 2021, and let's all work hard to make 2021 the best year ever. Thank you. See you next time.